Oh, hi. Welcome to your neighborhood AMC. Don't forget to buy some popcorn. Wait a minute. This is an AMC. This is YouTube. You're not at the movie theater, you're at home. Because most people are not at the movie theaters. Because most people are still afraid of getting sick. Even though more and more theaters are opening back up in the US, most are not packed full of people. Mostly, they're running empty or at very low capacity. So if movie theaters are not able to sell tickets to the movies, or their super expensive popcorn and sodas, why does the stock price of AMC keep going up? What is going on that pushes the stock price up and up and up, whereas there is no revenue for the company? Well, watch this video to find out. Guys, before we continue with this video, I want to take a second to ask you to please hit that like button and the subscribe button for the YouTube algorithm. This helps me out greatly and keeps me motivated to keep making these videos. That being said, let's get back to today's video. Now, let's get some background in AMC. AMC is the largest movie theater chain in the entire world, with over 1,000 locations and 10,000 screens. Pre-pandemic, their revenues in 2019 were over $5.4 billion. But in 2020, they had revenues of only $1.2 billion. They went from declaring a profit of about $110 million in 2019 to declaring a loss of $4.5 billion in 2020. Now, we all know the reason why revenues are so down. After all, people are not really going back into movie theaters yet. So why in the world is the stock price going up? Well, remember these guys? If this reminds you of the GameStop situation from earlier in the year, you're thinking along the right lines. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you should go and watch the GameStop squeeze video after this one, link in description. At the same time that retail investors forced a short squeeze in GameStop, AMC was also getting hyped up on the same subreddit, Wall Street Bets. However, it did not blow up like GameStop did. What did happen is that the short squeeze in GameStop proved that retail investors can indeed get together and hold on to a stock long enough to cause a short squeeze. And this is exactly what holders of AMC are trying to do right now. They want to create a short squeeze in AMC in order to make a boatload of money while making sure that the hedge funds that are betting against AMC lose a lot of money at the same time. Now, if you're wondering what a short squeeze actually is, let me give you a quick lesson. So let us say there's a hedge fund that's betting that the stock of AMC is going to go down. Now, at this time, it seems like a reasonable assumption. After all, not a lot of movie theaters are open, and even those that are open are not able to attract as many people as before. So this hedge fund might go ahead and buy put option or puts on AMC stock. This means that this hedge fund is betting against AMC and is betting that its stock price will go down within a certain time period. If this actually comes true, the hedge fund makes some money. The other thing that a hedge fund can do is go short on the company. In this scenario, the hedge fund will borrow the stock of whatever company they're trying to short and then promise the owner of the stock that they will return that stock at a later date. They then turn around and immediately sell the stock out on the open market. Let's say for $10. So if their bet is correct and the price of that company falls to, let's say, $5, they then buy that stock back for $5 and return it to its original owner. In this case, they profit $10 minus $5, so $5, minus the interest that they had to pay the original owner to borrow the stock in the first place. However, if their bet is wrong and the price of the stock rises to, let's say, $15, now they have to pay $15 to buy that same stock that they originally sold for $10 and return it to the original owner. In this case, they would lose the $5 difference plus the interest that they had to pay the original owner to borrow the stock in the first place. In a short squeeze, the price of the shorted stock increases, maybe because they announced a new service or product, or new management, or announced better than expected earnings. So when this happens, the price of the stock increases. And now the hedge fund has to buy the stock at increased price to cover their short position. When they do this, the demand for the stock goes up. And then basic economics kicks in. With higher demand come higher prices. And then the prices get higher and higher. And this becomes a cycle. And because of this, now hedge funds have to pay more and more money to buy back the shares that they had borrowed and have to return to fulfill their obligations. So this squeezes the hedge fund into a difficult position where they're spending much more money than they anticipated to cover their short position. And this is called a short squeeze. This is exactly what traders on Wall Street Bets are trying to do. They got proof of concept back in March with the GameStop squeeze, and they are trying to replicate the same situations with AMC. They are trying to make a lot of money by creating or forcing a short squeeze, while also making sure that hedge funds on the other side of the trade lose a lot of money, kind of like sticking it to the man. So the question arises is this: can there be a short squeeze in AMC? How high can the AMC stock go? And is it truly worth it? Let's try to answer some of these questions. So one of the prerequisites of having a short squeeze is a large short interest in a company. This means how many number of shares are actually borrowed and sold in the market by hedge funds to begin with. At its peak, GameStop had a short interest of 140%. However, for AMC, the highest short interest we've seen so far, which was reported on May 14th, was about 18%. So it is actually much, much, much lower than the short interest that GameStop had back in March. So it's possible that even if hedge funds have to cover all of their short positions, they might be able to do it relatively easily for relatively less money. Secondly, hedge funds got hurt during the GameStop crisis, so they are bound to be on guard this time. I think they will be definitely monitoring Wall Street Bets and other internet traffic on Twitter and other places to make sure they are not caught unawares. And because the short interest is so low as of this point, it is possible that if prices start rising, hedge funds will be able to cover their short positions relatively cheaply. So keeping in mind these two things, in my opinion, it might be a little hard for a short squeeze to set in on AMC stock in today's situation. That being said, anything's possible. Let's say a short squeeze does happen and AMC stock starts rising. How high can it go? Well, some people on Reddit are calling for the price of AMC stock to go all the way up to $100,000. The total number of outstanding shares of AMC common stock right now is a little over 500 million shares. So if the price of each stock goes to $100,000, the market cap of AMC would be over $50 trillion. The entire S&P 500 has a market cap of just around $37 trillion. Obviously, it is unreasonable to think that the market cap of AMC could exceed the market cap of all the companies within the S&P 500. So, now let us talk about what AMC stock has done so far this year. On January 4th, the first Monday of the year, AMC stock was trading around $2 per share. On January 27th, when the GameStop squeeze happened, AMC stock shot up to $20 per share before falling down to $10 a share, where it then traded for a long time. Starting week of May 24th of this year, AMC stock started rising up to get to a peak of $62 on Wednesday, June 2nd. And then it fell by June 4th, by the end of after trading hours, to just under $44. So what happened? Why did it go from $62 to $44 in just 2 days? After the price hit a peak of $62 on Wednesday, AMC announced that it will be selling 11 million new shares on the market. This caused the price to nosedive to below the $44 mark, where it sits right now when I'm recording this video. So what happens next? Is this it? Does the price get stable around here? Does it go up or fall down further? Holders on Reddit and on Twitter are saying that they believe in the stock and they intend to hold it long term. And they truly believe that a short squeeze is coming and they intend to make a lot of money while making sure the hedge funds hurt. Personally, I think this might be a little hard, but I also miss the GameStop situation, so what do I know? All I know is that it's all pure speculation, at least in my opinion, and far too risky for me to dip my toe in. I will just go on keep investing in the S&P 500, and thank you very much. So that's all I have for you guys in today's video. I hope you found this video helpful, interesting, and informative. If you did, please go ahead and smash that like button and the subscribe button for the YouTube algorithm. And also hit the bell icon to be notified instantly when I post a new video. I upload at least one new video every week with BAT Financial content, and I would love to see you back here. Also go ahead and follow me on Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter. I will leave the handles down in the description below. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.